everybody! Thanks for joining me again today and welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be my March wrap-up. So these are all the books that I've read in March. The first one that I've read is called Meet Cute, and this is a bunch of short stories by different authors about how couples first meet together, and it's really lovely and it's really heart-fluttering and heartwarming. There's a story for everyone, and I'm really glad to say that it has a lot of diversity in this. It includes LGBT and transgender as well. My most favorite story here is called The Dictionary of You and Me by Jennifer L. Armentrout. And it's about a girl who works in the library and she finds love through a missing book. I work in a library, so I can really relate in this, and it had the little teenage girl in me squealing with all the heart fluttering moments of this story. As I said before, it's about a girl who works in the library and there's an overdue book and she has to ring up the customer who has that overdue book, and over the time as they talk to each other on the phone, she starts to get to like him because he's very quirky and interesting, and he borrowed a dictionary, so he was telling her a lot of cool new words that he's learned in that dictionary. Over time, she gets to meet him in person and he was the new kid at school, and it's just really heartwarming, and I really recommend that, especially if you're into lighthearted fluffs. That's the story for you. I also like Click by Catherine McGee. It's a futuristic story about a girl who's meeting up a person through an app on the mobile phone. It's called Click, and the person that she met in real life wasn't the person that was meant to be her date, but it turned out to work out for the best because he is a whole lot better than her initial date, and she lost her phone and they were trying to track it down. During that course of the hunt, they got to know each other and sparks fly between them, and I really like that story, and it's one of the best ones in this book. I also like The Unlikely Likelihood of Falling in Love by Jocelyn Davis. It's about a girl who conducted an experiment because she met a boy in the New York subway, and she conducted an experiment, the likelihood of passing by him through the trains, of meeting him, and it was a series of experiments and probability. She did a lot of math, and it was a whole interesting process, and sometimes she gets to see him on the subway and sometimes she doesn't. And the conclusion was really funny and it's really good. I highly recommend that book as well. It has a really nice plot and premise to it, and it will leave anyone out there who loves YA romance squealing with delight. So I recommend that. And I also like the other story called Oomph by Emery Lord. And this is a girl-to-girl romance. It's about two girls who stumbled upon each other in an airport waiting for their flights. And they got talking and got to like each other, and the ending is really sweet as well, so I recommend you check out the ending because it's so cute. So I really like this book. I would rate this a 4.5 out of 5. I highly recommend this for YA lovers out there. This is a great book for a quick read, and if you like short stories as well, this is the book for you. The next book that I've read is called Midnight Sun by Trish Cook, and this is what it looks like. A movie will come out about this book starring Bella Thorne, and it's about a girl called Katie Price. She has a skin condition which is XP, and basically if she goes under the sun, if the sun touches her skin, she will get skin cancer, she will get blistering and burning, and she will basically die. It won't be pretty, and so most of her life was confined inside her house in her room with her dad. She has a cool dad and a really, really nice best friend. She often watches the world outside through her window, and she sees this guy, Charlie, and she's always had feelings for him since she was young. She only gets to live her life during nighttime when she goes to the local subway and play her songs. And in there, she meets Charlie, and from then on, they get to know each other and feelings develop. It's a really quick read. It's only around about 258 pages. I would say this book is aimed toward the younger teens, around 13 to 15 year olds. At times, the book can be a little bit too cheesy and corny. Like, everything just falls into place, and it seems too picture perfect and fairy tale type of romance. If you like that kind of thing, then you'll probably like this book. However, it was just a little bit too corny at times. Katie is good at everything that she does, and the guy just falls instantly in love with her. I feel like the romance in this book is too insta-lovey, and it didn't develop properly, like, through time. And It was just instant. The moment Charlie sees Katie, he immediately falls for her and likes her. I wasn't really that into this book. I would probably give it a 3 out of 5 stars. It was just an average read. Last but not least, I got Pretty Dead Girls by Monica Murphy. And this is another YA book. At first, I thought it was gonna be a paranormal type of book, but I was wrong. It centers around Penelope, and she goes to a school. She's belongs to the Larks, and they are a bunch of wealthy, popular, beautiful, talented girls. Everybody envies them, and they rule the school. One by one, the girls in the Larks started being murdered, started dying, and she's being connected to them, along with Cass, who's a boy in her physics class. The author got the inspiration for this story through Scream Queens, so if you like that TV show, you will like this one probably. However, I never watched that show, so I didn't really connect well with the character. Sad to say, I didn't really like this book because I felt like it was hard to connect with the character. It was really difficult for me to feel for her, to invest myself in her, because she was unrelatable. She was very catty, she's very shallow, self-absorbed, and self-centered. And they were very mean girls. All they do is backstab each other, call each other names behind their backs, and steal each other's guys and boyfriends, sleep around with other guys. And I feel like it's not the kind of character I would really like in real life and relate to. There's some romance in here, but I didn't feel invested to it because I never felt connected to the character. So just be warned, although it's not graphic, there is a sex scene in here, so if you're not into that, then you may want to skip this book. The story is a lot about murder mystery, finding out who's the killer and who done it, finding out who could it be. There's a lot of suspicion going on that it could be one of the Larks. There were two detectives investigating the whole crime, and they were just really annoying and very unrealistic, that they were just there to annoy people, and they weren't very realistic. Their dialogue was very stiff and unrealistic and very awkward, I think. So yeah, I didn't feel much for the character. I wasn't really into the story. I had to force myself to finish this book. And because of that, I would only give this book a 2 stars out of 5. This is one of the few rare books, YA books, that I didn't really like. If you're into murder mysteries, then perhaps you will like this. But none of the characters are nice and they're not friendly. They were very cruel and mean, so I just never liked the character and the story. So I didn't really like this book at all, sadly. That is it for my March wrap-up. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to check out my other videos in my channel. And I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye!